Yeah, after this recording, I think I ended up redoing this whole thing, this whole shot. The woman that I'm following,
I wonder why they only stole Lucan's golden claw. I mean, we have plenty of things.
She has a different
shop
head now in my game.
Coin.
This is when
Lucan
she still had a vanilla
about
head.
A year after he opened the store. He never quite explained where he got it.
But I never liked her face. Never, ever, ever. She just had the weirdest face, the weirdest lips. She had some strange mime makeup on. It was very bright, Tammy Faye Baker type makeup. A bit much, if you ask me. So she's just telling me how to get to Bleak Falls Barrow.
This is the bridge out of town. The path up the mountain to the northwest leads to Bleak Falls Barrow. I guess I should get back to my brother. He'll throw a fit if I take too long. He's such a child.
Yeah, it got dark quick. So I gotta hurry up and run there before it's nighttime. I'm using the default time scale, which is 20. I want to say for every second of real time, 20 seconds of game time goes by. Yeah, so I was just curious how well this guy fights that I found over at the Drunken Huntsman. I need to download more male NPCs for my game. Since I'm playing a female character, I've swapped out a lot of the female characters in my game for male characters, just to balance things out more.
You picked a bad mistake, lost.
I wish there was a way to not have an NPC say, "Is someone there?" when they're hit by something. When they get hit by a weapon, I don't want,
numbs my fingers any worse.
"Is someone there?" I don't want that coming out of their mouth ever. They get an arrow to the knee and they're like, "Is someone there?" There should be a flag or a condition. Check. Please don't say this if you've just been hit by somebody. That only needs to be said if it's dark and they can't see, and maybe they hear something, or they think they see you in the dark. Something like that. Chances are they're just going to hear what you're doing and not see you at all. Wearing a heavy outfit, you're going to make noises running in there. Running in their sacred ruin temple, cultist temple that only they are allowed in. You're an outsider. I can never know how many bandits are in this place. I always expect bunches of them, but there's usually just, three people? Three people in the whole thing? One guy outside and two guys inside? That's it. When I've had populated forts installed, there might be, you know, 6 or 7 guys all piled inside that little tower there, trying to kill me. Same here, there'd be like 20 guys running down the steps, coming at me with their magical weapons. But no, in a vanilla game like I'm playing here, it's going to be, I want to say, three people tops, up there waiting for someone to climb the steps. Look what we have here, you know, that kind of thing. We got ourselves a bleeder. No, that's from another game. That's from a better game, actually. It's called Fallout 3. And it doesn't need mods to play.
What was that?
I'm going to put you down!
One of these days, someone's going to make a Skyrim CE. I'd buy that for $1. Yeah, CE would be the complete edition. So when you buy Skyrim, you know that the game's complete. Not just empty alpha stage product like Legendary Edition and SE.
Let's
Special Edition are.
What do you need to take?
And when they sold Skyrim SE, they should have put on the box, warning, mods required. And then in smaller print, it should have said,
"Let's go."
Warning, there are no mods yet for this game. Please be patient. Mods will arrive shortly. In the coming months. Yeah, because you guys know that Skyrim LE and SE, basically just alpha products. Skeleton games. There was some content.
You, over here.
So many quests that were so binary in the game, though.
Where you go? Get me down from this.
You either kill everything and take their stuff, or you decide not to. I mean, that's basically how these quests would happen. Once or twice there'd be a quest that had a gray spot where you could be the good guy, you could be the bad guy, or you could be the person in the medium.
Get ready for a fight.
But with any post quest, there would always be, you know, at the end of every quest, you go running back to the NPC that told you to go do such and such, and then they would be your friend afterwards. This goes on many times in Skyrim. If you fail, then they're not your friend. So that's the binary part at the end of each quest. Either you gain a friend or you don't gain a friend. And that's one reason why I always liked Fallout 3, because Fallout 3 had gray spots. You could choose to side with somebody or not side with somebody, or maybe compromise and side with two people. Because with the Battleborn clan, they say Greymane. The guy says Greymane or Battleborn, and depending on what you answer, that's how the guy is going to feel about you for the rest of the game. So that's why you have sex mods. Sex mods fix everything. Solves all problems. Because if, let's say the guy hates you because you like the Stormcloaks, well, if you have sex with him, then he'll like you. and he won't care anymore that you like the Stormcloaks more than he does. Lit myself on fire. And the Draugrs, they don't accept prisoners, so I just died on the spot. I'm gonna have to fix that.
What was that?
If I get beat up in a Draugr dungeon, I don't want to just die because no one will take me prisoner. So there might be an option to have them take me prisoner.
Nicely done.
I had this one mod where you get taken prison, you get taken prisoner by bandits, and then you wait around while one of your friends comes to bring money to get you released. I thought that was the coolest thing ever. I can't remember what mod that was. Oh, what was that mod called? Alternate Death?
That'll
teach. Anyway, the reason why I just had the same death move over and over and over again is because I'm still brand new with the greatsword. I haven't learned much skill with it yet. So I only know one death move. Basically, if my stamina is full, I'm guaranteed a death move, no matter how badly I aim at the enemy. It's like a critical hit.
Glad you're making progress. My employers are anxious to have some tangible answers.
So we got Herman here with us. I found him at Bleak Falls Barrow. Herman the Mad.
Oh, have no fear. The Jarlim's finally taken.
I think that's the name of his mod. He's a Draugr that you can turn into a follower.
So I'm now able to devote most of my time to this research.
Time is running, Farengar, don't forget. This isn't some theoretical question. Dragons have come back.
Yes, yes, don't worry. Although the chance to see a living dragon up close would be tremendously valuable. Now, let me show you something else I found. Very intriguing. I think your employers may be interested as well. Hmm? Bah, yes, the Jarl's protege. Back from Bleak Falls Barrow. You didn't die, it seems. Ah, Dragonstone of Bleak Falls Barrow. Seems you are a cut above the usual brutes the Jarl sends my way. You'll have to see the Jarl about that. Maybe his steward, Avenichi. I'm sure one of them will pay you appropriately. My associate here will be pleased to see your handiwork. She discovered its location by means she has so far declined to share with me.
So your information was correct after all. And we have our friend here to
thank. So Herman says things. He has commentary.
Nice work. Just send me a copy when you've deciphered it.
Farengar, you need to come at once. A dragon's been sighted nearby. You should come too.
How exciting. Where was it seen? What was it doing?
I'd take this a bit more seriously if I were you. If a dragon decides to attack White. Let's go.
Okay, so Herman I want to say he's a vanilla follower, so if you have someone following you already,
tell him what you told me.
He won't follow you.
Oh, that's right. We saw it coming from the south. It was false.
So this guy who's walking into me, I have him on a leash. He's not really following me. So when I come over to talk to Livia, she totally ignores me. There's no option for her to follow me at all. So I thought I'd go bug Lydia down here.
The Jarl has appointed me.
Her face is all dark.
It's an honor to serve you.
So this is basic Lydia.
Lead the way.
She's got the heroic body. She's got less makeup on. She has mature skin. She's a specialized follower, so she has specialized skills and powers.
What's on your mind? Very good, ma'am. Yes, my Thane?
So I need her to go and
I'll head back home if you need me.
Yeah. I was having a brain fart. I thought maybe she had a breeze home, but we don't have breeze home. So she just lives here at Dragon's Reach.
I am your sword and your shield. Until next time. Good day.
In her walk, I was just looking at her walk style. She's slightly walking with her arms outward, like the men, their arms hang outward because of the armor they wear, and she's using a sexy walk, which
long life to you, Thane.
Moves her elbows closer to her hips. So her elbows rub on her hips, but she's got armor on, so it looks kind of funny.
Yes, my lady?
But when she does a regular pose, like standing pose, her arms should be out instead of just hanging straight down.
You lead, I'll follow.
Yeah, see, they're hanging out instead of hanging straight down. And I have a mod that installed right now that lessens the amount of arms sticking outward when you stand, because everyone has their arms
back.
The default is everyone has their arms sticking out to their side, like they've been pumping iron all day. See, and then when she walks, her arms switch to sexy mode when she walks. When she stops walking, her arms switch to more manly. Yes, see, now she's using her more manly.
I understand.
Elbows outward pose.
Excellent. I think you'll be glad that you made this decision. Thank you. I'll be sure to put it to good use.
I normally give NPCs a default outfit.
Good day.
To wear. That way, when they do become a companion of mine, I can just give them whatever armors they need to wear, and they'll put it on. Because anything's better than the clothes they come with if they're heading to battle. Anyway, so the whole point of coming here was to get her to follow
it's
me.
You. I knew you made it out of Helgen alive.
We're not doing
that.
That
dragon had no chance of stopping you.
Please tell me I chopped this out. Please. Please tell me.
Maybe. Maybe. You see, I have been searching around Skyrim for... Do you truly not remember me? I hoped.
Okay, I'm just gonna fast forward through it then.
You being captured at Dark. Thank you. I did not know. Now you know. You were nothing. Which is why I'm going to join your journey. And I knew you would say that. Just say the word when you're ready to travel with me.
And when I say the word, she won't travel with me. So I go on the internet, or not the internet, I go into her file, her ESP file, and I see that she's using some archaic method of friending people so that she will follow them. It's an obscure rule that she's using. I guess for future use, the plan was in the future she will not count as a follower. But right now she counts as a vanilla follower. But she's got this weird code in her plugin that no one uses anymore for recruiting NPCs into companions. And that code of hers is conflicting with Herman the Mad, the Draugr that I had following me. As long as I have Herman the Mad installed in my game, she won't ever follow me because her follow code seems to overwrite or get overwritten by Herman the Mad's code. Because Herman the Mad was written 6 years ago. 6 years ago when people didn't know how to mod followers yet for Skyrim. So he's got all kinds of problems with his ESP.
Again last night for a drink at the Bannered Mare.
Heard about that, did you? Yes, I went out for a pint or two.
So I ditched the Herman the Mad mod. So that guy's gone. It's as if I never went to Bleak Falls Barrow.
I understand.
So I'm gonna have to do Bleak Falls Barrow again. Now that Herman the Mad's been uninstalled. But at least the Olivia character now says, or I can now say to her, follow me, I need you, Obi-Wan, you're our only hope, kind of nonsense dialogue that I do. And I was checking to see if the immersive winches talk to any of the NPCs in this room. No one's buying drinks from them. Okay, let's give her a face light. Okay, see, now she'll follow me. So her follower scheme isn't interfering with one from a mod written 6 years ago.
Speak your mind.
So now I'm wondering what other archaic...
I'm heading home if you need me.
...code methods... is this follower using that are going to surprise me again later on in my playthrough when I need her to do something and she acts like we never met kind of a deal. Is that how you follow me? Start calling her Saran.
Ah, good to see you again. Looks like
this guy I have on a leash, so he doesn't count as a follower.
Thank you. Here, this is for you.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, so the immersive winches are talking to people that live here. That's cool.